I feel like after seeing Hitman, my question of can Glenn Powell be the lead of a film has been answered. Hello, everyone. Chance here with Hollywood Already Did It. If you haven't already, go ahead, like, share, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, ring that bell below. Anytime we have something, you will be among the first to know. I haven't done a movie review in a while, a solo one that's not attached to the podcast in a while. And Netflix has dropped a new film called Hitman, directed by Richard Linklater, who has done Boyhood, School of Rock, his gamut sort of all over the place, the Befores and After Sunsets. That's his shit. This time he's doing a romantic action comedy noir. It's a mixed genre of film, and we'll get on that a little bit as to how I feel about the movie. Based on a magazine article of the same name that was in a publication called Texas Monthly. And it is about a man played by Glenn Powell, Gary Johnson, who is a professor and tech man who winds up being an undercover mole for the New Orleans police. And his job is to sort of act as a hitman to get people to sort of entrap themselves, if you will. It's sort of entrapment, but to coerce themselves into going through with the idea of payment to actually have someone killed. An interesting thing happens in this movie, what it's a pretty good concept, is people are keep asking, where do you think you find these people? You think they're just people out there who are just that movies and TV and whatnot have made us believe that there's people that you can call at a whim's notice to say, hey, I need you to take care of this for me. And there's some people out there who are in dire enough situations or poor enough income that they will believe that. That's not what this film's about. What occurs is that we get to see Glenn Powell put on a pretty solid acting showcase. I will say that after watching this film, if nothing else, however I feel about the movie, I do think that Glenn Powell puts on an acting performance that has made me believe that he could be a leading man in a multitude of films. He is both charismatic, funny, and willing to sort of demystify how good he looks to portray the role. I feel like this movie is at its best when it's a comedy, when it's doing the, hey, I'm dressing up as all these different versions of this to sort of get the job done. That's when it's the best for me. That's when I'm the most interested and invested. When it starts switching into becoming a romantic comedy, I love the two leads. I love Glenn Powell as Gary, and I really like Adria as Madison. Those two work, and their relationship works. It just becomes a little clunky out of the context of what we were getting at the beginning, which was this comedy about this man doing all of these things for the police, to a romantic comedy, then becoming sort of a murder mystery LA noir. The things don't quite jive or gel that way that well together, because the plot to connect them all is really paper thin. I think what this movie has going for it is two charismatic leads, and it's fun. But when you start pulling at threads and actually thinking about the movie, it's kind of like, eh, I don't care that much about any of these characters outside of them going on this ride. But I will say it's probably the most fun film that Richard has made and directed since School of Rock. That's like just, I'm not doing this for the romance or the love or this artsy, super artsy thing. It's like, I'm just gonna have fun with it. He does just have fun with it. And I think some fans of his who go into this thinking they're gonna get more, a little bit more headier, you're not getting that. But there's some genuine chemistry between Glenn Powell and Adria, and I like both of them in this, and I would love to see them go on and do. I am more interested in watching Twisters now because I'd like to see him be a leading man and something that has a little bit more bite to it. I don't think Twisters' script is going to be mind-blowing in comparison to what we have here either, but I do think he will be a leading man, and can he carry a big action vehicle is the sort of next thing that I think folks want to see. But I think I am now on the train of Glenn Powell. I'm like, all right, cool. Let me see what else he can do. What Because he put on a pretty solid acting clinic here that I, as paper thin as the script is, his performance is what kept me watching from start to finish. And that says a lot, because the movie itself is not that, for me anyway, is not that good, but he made it watchable from start to finish. And so it's not a film that I would recommend to people. I don't think I would ever watch this one again, but just in my head, I'm like, if you want to watch him and what he's capable of and what I think the future of Glenn Powell looks like, you should check out Hitman. So on my scale of 1, Play It Again, Sam, 2, I didn't mind that. 3, once is enough. Or 4, give me a time stone so I never have to think about this film again. This is a 3. This is going to be a once is enough. Not because it's a terrible film. I don't think it's a bad film at all. I just don't think that there is enough happening in the story for me to revisit this, to recommend this. It's very paper-thin stories, but it's a very good acting performance by Glenn Powell and Adria. The two of them combined put on a good enough performance that it's fun. At the end of the day, sometimes you just want fun, mindless fun, just sort of cut on and put on. I think it gets a little jumbled when we're jumping from genre to genre. And my favorite genre for me was at the beginning when he was dressing up as all these different versions of the Hitman. Once that stops and he is sort of stuck in the Ron world, it becomes a little less interesting of a film for me. But what did you guys think about Hitman? Go ahead and leave your thoughts and comments in the comments below. If you haven't already, you can follow us on Twitter at HollywoodADI. You can hit us up on email at HollywoodAlreadyDidIt@gmail.com. We also have a podcast by the same name. That's a Google Podcast, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, anywhere that plays podcasts, we're there. And like always, I got my ticket. You got yours.